Han Shan returned to Shu, but Wu snatched Jing. Given Liu Bei's temperament, he will certainly attack Sun Quan. Tell the generals they are not to move until after those two have clashed.
Oh, Cao Cao!
I just have one more message to send out. I will rest after that.
You had better.
Right.
The land is still not settled. Therefore, you cannot allow the traditional ceremonies
for my funeral. There is no need to mourn. Our men must not leave their posts. Everyone must attend to their duties.
Cao Cao, just this once. You must forgive us. Just this once.
Your plan was brilliant, men of Wu. Go ahead and strike me down.
Guan Yu, you could come and fight for me. Sun Wu would welcome you. And your strength as a fighter.
Master. I'm sorry for interrupting. But it isn't exactly his fighting. It was his devotion. It was his close bond with Liu Bei that made him Guan Yu.
Exactly. I have given my life for the wishes of my oath brother, Liu Bei.
I see. I believe that is what you said when you left Cao Cao as well.
You have my thanks, Liu Bei. I am glad to be taken by the hand of one who knows me.
It is the basis of my strategy to know my enemy. That is all it is.
In that case...
The House of Sun Wu has defeated Guan Yu, God of War!
Together, Ling Tong and Gan Ning defeated the God of War, Guan Yu, under the direction of Lu Meng. However, Lu Meng succumbed to illness, depriving Wu of one of its strongest pillars. Ling Tong and Gan Ning worked together to support Wu. Eventually, they were faced with the Battle of Yiling, a massive Shu army led by Liu Bei invaded Wu's territory. Gan-Ning found himself surrounded by the Shu forces, and his life was in danger. Despite his grumbling, Ling Tong immediately set out for the battlefield, determined to save his friend.
You're really that scared of him? If you don't think you'll stand a chance with him, then you can always fight me.
Hell, brother.
Now then, running out all alone like that, what were you thinking?
Huh? I was just giving you a chance to shine. Wait, didn't you just run off some strange guy over there?
You saw that?
Yeah, well, thanks.
It's going to cost you.
I am Sima Zhao, Grand Commander of the Wei Armies. You are Liu Chan, Emperor of Shu, right? Tell me. Have you decided?
Yes. Let us end this now. As long as this fighting continues, then so will the grief. Master Sima Zhao, I do have a request to make.
And that is?
Will you carry on our dream as well? We always dreamed of a wise rule. And of a new world that is completely without any sadness or chaos.
I cannot make that promise. But I'll try to make it come true in this new age that I'm creating.
I thank you. That is sufficient. Then I will surrender the Shu.
I accept your surrender. Chaos shall end.
Zhang Wei, forgive me for causing you such pain, but Lord Sima Zhao has been gracious enough to allow us to commune with each other again.
Lord Chan, why? Why did you surrender? We could still fight. We could have fought. and achieved all of the Prime Minister's wishes. Why?
I won't ask you to forgive me, but I am sick of the fighting. I have absolutely no desire for it.
You have forced us to yield from the moment you decided to give up.
Jiang Wei. You have always given me your all and truly done your very best serving the House of Shu. But it is all over now. There is no more need to bear that burden.
How can...
Speak no more, Jiang Wei. With this, Shu's battle is finally over.
Xing Cai and the other officers fought bravely, but Chengdu still fell in defeat. Liu Chen surrendered to Wei, thereby bringing an end to the kingdom of Shu. Xing Cai was banished to Luoyang, along with Liu Chen. There, she would live out the rest of her days in peace, away from the battlefield. However, her heart remained in her homeland, in the country where memories of her father, brother, and so many others resided.
Xing Cai.
Lord Liu Chan, are you all alone? It's dangerous without bodyguards.
It's okay. I doubt that anyone wants to kill me now. And so, I am releasing you from your duties.
My lord, what do you mean?
You have helped me for so long. I believe you should have time to rest. So, what about taking a trip? When you have seen enough, come back to me. I'll be waiting for you.
I am Sima Zhao, Grand Commander of the Wei Armies. You are Liu Chen, Emperor of Shu, right? Tell me. Have you decided?
Yes. Let us end. end this now. As long as this fighting continues, then so will the grief. Master Sima Zhao, I do have a request to make.
And that is?
Will you carry on our dream as well? We always dreamed of a wise rule, and of a new world that is completely without any sadness or chaos.
I cannot make that promise. But I'll try to make it come true in this new age that I'm creating.
I thank you. That is sufficient. Then I will surrender the shoe.
I accept your surrender. Chaos shall end. Finally, one of the problems facing us has now been fully solved.
What are you saying, Zhao? There's still the final move to be made.
What move?
The execution of the Shu Emperor, Liu Chang. We must carve this defeat deep into the hearts of all the losers. And they must never forget that they have lost the battle.
And you're saying that that is the life of Liu Chang?
There is nothing that will work better.
We're not doing that, Hu Chong. I'll strive for a world without grief. That is what I told Liu Chang. I vowed I would not betray that.
Even if that weakness someday brings back the chaos?
You're wrong. People find peace by forgiving others. Isn't that right? Yes. Even Sun Wu.
Show me that you can end the chaos following this so-called path of yours.
I will. You just watch me.
Jia Cheng quickly carried out the invasion of Shu. Liu Chen surrendered and was banished to Luoyang, where he was given the honorific title of Duke of Anlu. Sima Zhao set out to dispatch the remaining Wu forces. Along the way, Jia Cheng calmly carried out his duties. He would devise brilliant strategies and eliminate any who stood in his way. All so that Sima Zhao could unite the land.
Go.
Hey, hold on. What are you doing here?
I should be asking you the same thing. Aren't you supposed to be working right now?
You caught me. I was at an impasse and looking for a new place to take a nap.
I'm sure I have enough people watching over me. Can you kindly stop with the obvious act?
Watching you? What are you talking about?
Okay, if you want to keep it up,
about to take a nap, you should go back to your own room.
Don't get your hands dirtier than you have to. If this goes on, thanks just won't be enough anymore.
Whatever are you talking about?